up, what's happening, what is going on, folks? It's a beautiful day here in the Pocono Mountains of Pennsylvania as we welcome you to the one and only Pocono Raceway for stop number 16 of the 2022 Mission Barbecue Cup Series season, the Jack Frost Big Boulder Ski Resort 400. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, lads of all ages, as we welcome you to the track with live coverage on the North American Sim Racing Network, and from high in the sky in the press box, my name is Trey Wright for the NASRN. 40 laps are on the docket for today's race around this 2.5-mile tricky triangle in Long Pond, Pennsylvania. We are set to go racing here with 10 races left before the 2022 edition of the MBCS Chase. We'll get into your points in just a few moments, but it's Pocono, baby. What turn four? There is no turn four. One of the most unique tracks we go to on the MBCS circuit. And hey, it's my personal favorite track. It's my home track, so great to be back in Pocono Mountains, just a couple of hours away from my home in New Jersey. At least my home track in real life with a couple of other tracks. Yada yada, I'm not going to get into that. Let's get into your recap of last week's race at the Dover International Speedway, in which Mitchell Collins ran away, utterly dominated the M&M's 400 at the Monster Mile. He starts 17th on the grid this afternoon, but his Yellow Monkey Racing teammate and team owner, Diego Vasquez, starts on the front row. This marks the fourth race in a row a Yellow Monkey Racing car has started on the front row. So I don't know what those guys are doing in qualifying, but it is working. Think of guys like Brennan Wilmington and your two points leaders, Keegan Thompson and Jesse Turner, could have used their notes in qualifying. All those guys start way in the back of the field. And it's now officially get into your points standings coming into race 16 of the season. At the drop of the green flag today, the final 10 races before the chase will officially begin. Keegan Thompson is still out front. He has increased his points lead by 85 points over Jesse Turner. Ryan Durrani is third in the points. He remains in third in the points. Brennan Wilmington remains in fourth. And the only change in the top five was Roberto Crown Jr., who has risen five positions in the point standings. Keegan Thompson and Jesse Turner had absolutely horrific qualifying runs. They start 42nd and 41st, respectively. Ryan Durrani starts P12 on the grid. Brennan Wilmington, he has been abysmal in qualifying all season long. He starts P35. And Roberto Crown Jr. starts P13 in the 21 machine. Braden Perez, Logan Williams, your defending winner from last season, Will Parrish, Dano Giorgi, and Mitchell Collins round out your top 10. And with 10 races left, those wild card positions become ever the more so valuable, with Justin Zidell and Juan Rodriguez currently the two drivers holding on to those wild card positions at the moment. So guys like Elijah Gordon and guys that have also won, like Charlie Davenport, they have really, really got to step up their game if they want a chance of making the chase this season. But Eric Monaco starts up front. He's good on the super speedway tracks. He's already got a win in the bank, but he has got to have a near perfect next 10 races if he wants a chance at that wild card position, because that's the only way Eric Monaco and guys like him are going to get up in the chase. We'll get into the finer details later on in the broadcast, but it's now time for the moment you've all been waiting for, that time of the broadcast again, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go down trackside to get the most famous words in motorsports to kick off the Jack Frost 400 from the Tricky Triangle.
Drivers, start your engines.
The engines roar to life on the pit lane here at Pocono. We're just moments away from dropping the green flag for today's race. John Andrews starts on the pole position. He leads the field off of one of the longest pit lanes in the Mission Barbecue Cup Series. Like we mentioned in the pre-race, Diego Vasquez starts on the outside pole. The rest of the starting lineup on the left-hand side of your screen. Set to be a fun one as they enter turn one. Your race analysis at the bottom left hand side of your screen. Like we said, it's going to be a 40 lap race around this 2.5-mile three turn racing facility in Long Pond, Pennsylvania. Your pit window should be between 25 and 30 laps, a single stop race. And the banking, all three corners are radically different than one another. Turn one, steep 14 degrees, modeled after turn one from Trenton Raceway. Turn two, the tunnel turn, flat 8 degrees, flat 8 degrees, 90 degree corner modeled after the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Now they're entering the tunnel turn. And turn 3, that flat turn 3 of only 6 degrees modeled after the turns at the Milwaukee Mile. We will be going to all three of those tracks later in the season. So this will be a little bit of a preview of what to see at Trenton, Indy, and Milwaukee. And your two previous winners of the Jack Frost 400 were Jonathan Logan in 2020, Logan Williams in 2021. Jonathan Logan is no longer on the NBCS circuit. Logan Williams is, and he starts in 24th. And there are your 2 points leaders, Thompson and the 43, all the way back in row 21. Let's see if they can make up some ground in this one. We're going to have to see what these guys can do after 40 laps. They're out of turn 3. They're down the longest front straightaway in all of NR 2003. John Andrews will see the green flag, and we are live at the Tricky Triangle. Three wide, four positions, they exit the tunnel turn, down the short chute, into the flat turn 3. And oh, Garlington goes around in front of the pack! Monaco and Ethan Lewis caught up in it as well, and the yellow flag is out for the first time this afternoon on the first lap. And Monaco, who had a shot to do well in the race, has already been caught up in an accident. Cameron Garlington, who is also down deep in the points, going around, entering turn 3. And the yellow flag is out for the first time this afternoon. Andrews led them back to the stripe. Zachary Fitzwater, Garlington's teammate, gained a lot of ground on the start. He's out now in second after starting fifth, so already plus 3 for Fitzy. But for his teammate, Fitzwater is not Cameron Garlington's teammate. I apologize. That honor belongs to the Daytona 500 champion of Elijah Gordon, if we can find him. He's his manufacturer teammate, so I didn't completely F that one up. But speaking of F'd up, that is a lot of side damage to the driver's side of the 75 machine. Monaco will likely come down the pit lane to repair some damage, but he is going to be marred in the back of the field. And may see some guys hit the pit lane early on. And they could potentially stretch it from here. The max they can go is about 35 laps. And we're seeing some guys gamble on the pit lane. Derek Hamill elects to stay out. But here comes the majority of the field down the pit lane. Couple of stragglers remain on the racing surface, but we'll follow with John Andrews and see what he does on pit road here at Pocono. If you're just tuning in, under caution for the first time this afternoon for a three-car accident entering the flat turn 3. And I imagine it's just going to be a splash and go for a lot of these guys. We'll see what Andrews does. You see a lot of the guys already out, and it is indeed splash and go for pretty much the majority of the field. But for guys like Eric Monaco and Ethan Lewis and Cameron Garlington, those three are going to be on the pit lane for an extended amount of time. But Derek Hamill, team owner for Macklin Hamill Enterprises, remains on the pit lane along with six other drivers. So the top seven stayed out. Let's take a look and see what happened to bring out the first caution of the afternoon here at the Pocono Raceway as Roberto Crown Jr. has a slow stop. But Eric Monaco, Cameron Garlington, and Ethan Lewis were caught up in an accident. Let's finally go take a look and see what happened to bring out the first caution of the afternoon here at the Pocono Raceway in the Jack Frost 400. So three wide entering turn 3. Garlington is just going to move up a little bit. It's going to get pinched by Monaco right into the entrance of the turn. I think Ethan Lewis is just going to run into the back of Eric. A little bit, yeah, just kiss his ass just a little bit there. No homo. But Monaco sustains a lot of damage to the driver's side of that Hurs Camry. And I think Garlington just had a little bit of damage from backing it into the outside wall. Thankfully, the safer barrier was there to deaden the impact. I don't think that's going to affect his aerodynamics too much. It doesn't look like he has a whole lot of damage. But nonetheless, take another look at this accident in real time. Then we'll get you back to the action here at the Pocono Raceway. Falling with Cameron Garlington in real time just gets pinched by Monaco entering turn three. Ethan Lewis just makes slight contact with the 75. But that is enough to throw out the yellow flag. And thankfully, it was just only a three-car accident. It could have been a lot worse as everybody moves to get out of the way of the stricken 7 machine. But John Andrews led them back to the line, but everybody except the top 7 stayed out. So Derek Hamill will inherit the lead, and he will most likely be your leader on the restart here at the Pocono Raceway in the Jack Frost Big Boulder Ski Resort 400. We're back here at the Pocono Raceway, wrapping up our first caution of the afternoon. Nobody was knocked out from that accident, but Roberto Crown Jr. was on the pit lane for quite a while. Not sure what the issue was there, but he is going to catch up to the back end of the field. He's got to hustle to get to the inside of all these guys. This could be interesting with a 21 getting back up here. Beer top five going back through the Reese's restart zone are Derek Hamill, Elijah Gordon, Thomas Troxell, Zachary Davis, and the 25 of Nathan Smith. Let's see, Roberto. I don't think he's going to get there in time. His green flag is back out in the air. We'll see if Crown Jr. can pull a Kyle Busch and leapfrog the field. I don't think that's going to be the case because he is miles ahead of everybody. He might be able to, but not. I think the majority of the pack is going to be up to speed by the time they enter the tunnel turn. Elijah Gordon to the inside of Hamill for the top spot. Troxell waiting in the wings. And nobody is on fresher tires. Everybody's on the same set of stickers that they started the race with. Troxell to the inside of the 88 for second. See, Crown Jr., yeah, he didn't get the jump on anybody. That's going to mar him towards the back of the field once again. But Hamill retains the lead. Troxell now in second. Gordon back in third. Nathan Smith passes the one for fourth. And can we get a green flag lap in? Yes, we can. Garlington down on the inside. A little bit slow in the 28, but we remain green for now. As the top three pull away from Nathan Smith in the 25, who is having the best run of his season thus far. And both of his teammates have wins. Actually, excuse me, no, Matt Wolf does not have a win. We have barely talked about Matt Wolf at all this season. Trying to find where he is. There he is in the 84. And there's been a couple of guys like that in the field where we have just barely seen them on the grid. Guys like, we've seen plenty of Daniel Bouchard when he's wrecking, but guys like Tyler Reynolds, Aiden McCrow, who is still yet to lead a lap this season. He has had a horrible job of defending his title. Guys like John Andrews, your pole sitter, we have barely seen him this season. Mitchell Collins, with the exception of last week's win at Dover. Noah Clifton, I've always forget that he's in this series. A lot of guys have been very quiet. Will Parrish. It just Full Frontal Motorsports as a whole has been just deathly quiet throughout the 2022 campaign. None of these drivers have a win. Will Parrish has been close a couple of times, and he's been in the top 10 in points for a couple weeks now. So everybody's going to go down to the inside as for the lead. Troxell passes Hamill. And these guys are really breaking, entering the flat turn three. So it looks like that is going to be the dominant passing zone as this race goes along. But now Gordon wants the lead from Troxell to the inside of the double zero goes the double eight. Drag race down Long Pond. and it's a drag race for third between Hamill and the one. Davis is going to get a draft slipstream from Nathan Smith, but Elijah Gordon now out front here at Pocono. And they are getting really racy towards the front of the field. Now Nathan Smith ducked down to the inside of the 47. And Gordon beginning to pull away, trying to get his third win of the 2022 season. And with 10 races to go, unless a guy like, unless Juan Rodriguez or Justin Zeidel gets a third win, that 88 is looking to essentially lock up a wild card position in the chase. But other than winning, Gordon has been so freaking inconsistent. Actually, I shouldn't say that. He's been consistently towards the back of the field or wrecking. It's been a very up and down rookie campaign for the 88. Troxell, it's been mostly down. But he is right on the back bumper of Elijah Gordon, looking for his first win of his Mission Barbecue Cup Series career. I go back, trying to find Logan Williams. There is Williams in the 17. Last year's winner, currently running in the 23rd position. So a bit of a slow start for Logan Williams, but anything can happen. But I'm liking these guys staying out, because unless we get a late caution, I like this strategy that guys like Derek Hamill, Thomas Troxell, Elijah Gordon, I like the strategy that they played of staying out at, under that first yellow. They will have to pit, but unless we get a late race yellow, those guys that pit on lap three will have to come down the pit lane as well. And it should set these guys up as the advantage. But Ethan Lewis is horrendously slow on the racetrack. He's met minimum speed, and I don't think he's gonna be a lap down factor. But here's the battle for the points lead at the moment. I think that, yeah, that is the battle for the points lead, because Ryan Durrani has fallen all the way back to 23rd. Roberto Crown Jr. is all the way back. In fact, the highest running guy in the top 10 in points is Will Parrish. And just as I say that, he is falling all the way outside the top 15. Troxell back down to the inside of Elijah Gordon for the top position. 12 laps down of the scheduled 40 here at Pocono. The top five pulling away from Fixie and the 54 of Diego Vasquez. And despite the tires beginning to wear out, they're still getting really, really racy up towards the front. They're still getting incredible runs on one another. And hopefully we'll see the next gen car run similar to this here at Pocono, because this has been thoroughly entertaining with your top five all nose to tail, or not only nose to tail, but they are side by side continuing to run next to each other for the race lead, continuing to get huge runs through the corners and battle it out. Troxell back to the race lead in the double zero. He's going to have his Toyota teammate behind him. And rounding out your top three, shocker, shocker, the Ford, the number 78 Ford of Justin Zeidel. But here comes Elijah Gordon back down looking for the final podium position. He's going to get it from Zeidel. Thought he cleared him off the corner. They'll drag race down the back. A little more than a quarter of a mile down the back straightaway here. The long pond straightaway at Pocono. So they enter turn two. And now, just as I praise them, now they're not going to go single file. They're not going to choo-choo at the moment as Derek Hamill dives back down to the inside of the double zero. Back in here now, it's Jesse Turner making strides. At the moment, I believe Keegan Thompson would still have the points lead. Yeah, they're 242 points ahead of Ryan Durrani, and Durrani's going nowhere. So this is the battle for the points lead at the moment. Right, which is essentially the battle for last place. Thompson still has it unless the 43 finishes like 15 positions ahead of the 14. Hamill now back out in front. And even though he's already led a lap in the race, it's not a race on the NASRN without us missing a pass for the race lead. And you gotta think, some of the guys that came down the pit lane, the first up in the pack is Diego Vasquez, and he is storming like a madman, cutting his way like a 1,000-degree knife through butter. And he's gone from 6th to 4th in the span of that lap. He's got Fitzwater. He had Fitzwater. Now Fitzwater goes back out on the high lane to the double zero. Oh, Nathan Smith almost had it in on his former teammate. Smith will try the high lane. I don't think that's going to work out enough for the 25. Vasquez looking for third on Troxel. Fourth. Looking to retake fourth. But Hamill and Zidel pulling away. Now remember, these guys are on a different strategy than the other 37 odd cars on the grid. Where they stayed out under the first caution. Everybody else came down the pit lane, and they will have to make a pit stop in about 10 to 15 laps. But they're scooting away. Everybody's on the same tire, so it just comes down to fuel. But if this race remains caution free, as 36 of Josh Williamson with an issue, caution is not out, but I believe he blew an engine right towards the middle of the field, because they are stacked on top of one another. As Keegan Thompson has now gotten in front of Jesse Turner as they enter through turn three. And I'm not sure what the issue was there. Well, actually, we do know what the issue was there, but that is split up the packs into two separate groups. And Williamson cannot make it around. He's stalled on the racetrack, and it looks like it was a flat tire for the 36. So that is definitely a bummer for Josh Williamson, who finished third last week at Dover. But meanwhile, Vasquez, who started second, is charging his way through the field. He's leading Zidel behind him. And the Chevrolets continue to fall back into the wings. But Hamill has now pulled away from the top five just a little bit. He's still only 0.4 of a second away, but this is the largest interval for the race lead that we've seen all race long. And just as I say that, Vasquez getting a huge toe off the 47 Camry, and he is going to get a nice slipstream down Long Pond, entering the tunnel turn. Not enough to make a pass through the flat turn two, but through Discount Milwaukee, he's going to set his sights on the inside of Hamill, and that is exactly what he's going to do. Oh, he had to check up there. Loses a bit of his momentum. It's going to fall into the advantage of Thomas Troxel, who's going to go to the inside three wide for second for a brief moment. That's exactly what Hamill wants to see out of his rearview mirror. Williamson still on the pit lane. This time by will be the halfway point in the Jack Frost Big Boulder Ski Resort 400 from the Pocono Raceway. And we will get you a full field rundown presented by Exalta once the field crosses the start-finish line to mark the halfway point through today's race. Hamill, through turn three, will lead the field through, cross-flagged from the flag stand, halfway home through today's race at Pocono. Let's get you your full field rundown presented by Exalta. Derek Hamill currently leads the way here at Pocono. Thomas Troxell right behind him. Diego Vasquez in third. Top three. Nose to tail. You could cover them with a thumbtack. Nathan Smith waiting in the wings in fourth. Zachary Fitzwater rounds out your top five. Zadell is sixth. Alex Lozano seventh. Elijah Gordon eighth. Mitchell Collins ninth. Rounding out your top 10 is Nathan Stapleton. 11th is Brennan Wilmington. A huge gains for the 62 team today. 12th is Noah Clifton. 13th is the five of Cole Sampson. 14th is Sampson's brother of Riley. 15th is Brennan Yodel. 16th is John Andrews. 17th is Matt Wolf. 18th is Will Parrish. 19th is Daniel Bouchard. And 20th is Zachary Davis. 21st is Logan Alexander. 22nd is Charlie Davenport. 23rd is last year's winner of Pocono, Logan Williams. 24th is Keegan Thompson, your points leader. 25th is Trey Smith. 26th is Juan Rodriguez. 27th is the 81 of Jordan Lopez, 28th is Ryan Durrani. 29th is Jesse Turner. And 30th is Caleb Rose. 31st is Aiden McCrell. 32nd is Eric Monaco. 33rd is Owen Miles. 34th is Trey Smith. So Daisy Johnson was all the way up in here. I still can't decipher the team Velocistar cars from one another. 36th is Daniel Georgi. 37th is Madison Tall. 38th is Cameron Garlington. 39th is 38th is Braden Perez. 39th is Tyler Reynolds. And 40th is a 21 of Roberto Crown Jr. 41st is a 7 of Elijah. I don't know what his name is. Ethan Lewis. And here we go. Back to the battle for the race lead. I don't know where the 36 of Josh Williamson is. Well, there's Josh Williamson, so I must have mistakenly said he was on the lead lap. He is, in fact, four laps down. But we got to get back to the race lead because they are all over one another. Vasquez takes the race lead away. And they have jumbled it back up for the top position. And Yellow Monkey Racing. I commented them on how well they were doing on the pit lane. And they're doing pretty well here on in the actual race, with Vasquez obviously leading and Mitchell Collins finding himself up inside the top 10, currently running 8th in the 45, looking to be the second driver to go back to win back-to-back races. And the only other driver to do that was none other than today's pole sitter, John Andrews. Andrews has fallen really back in the 44, back in 16th. But it is Vasquez in the 54, currently running up front. And remember, Vasquez and all these guys, pretty much the rest of the field, aside from seven cars, came down the pit lane for a splash and go on lap three. So they are able to stay out for an extra couple of laps. But guys like Thomas Troxell, Justin Zidell, Nathan Smith, Derek Hamill, and a couple of other guys, they're going to have to come down in any lap now between lap 25 and 30. So the window is open for those seven cars to hit the pit lane. And Will Parrish will be the first one to come down. And he was the only one to come down, trying his luck at short pitting. And I don't think they were going to catch Ethan Lewis either way. But Parrish, I don't know. We'll see if anybody else comes down the pit lane. Parrish will obviously beat these guys out. Now the question is, when these guys do pit, do they leave enough time for Parrish to potentially leapfrog them? Will was the only one that came down, so I don't know if there was potentially a mechanical issue, if it was an unscheduled pit stop. Doesn't say it was a mechanical failure. So I think this was scheduled for the 40, but he's all the way in the back of the field. Trey Smith is currently your fastest lap. So the bridesmaid of the Mission Barbecue Cup Series is probably going to be married here in the Pocono Mountains with the fastest lap. Patroxel to the inside of the 54, but he may be coming down the pit lane, and he is. And the top seven, or those seven cars that stayed out, will hit the pit lane. Now the question is, did they allow Will Parrish to put enough time on them to where he can leapfrog them? We all know, obviously, what the call from each of the pit boxes are going to be. Four fresh Hoosier tires, a full gas tank of Octane Racing fuel. We'll see where Will Parrish comes out in relation to these guys. There's the seven. And there is Parrish. A quick stop for Elijah Gordon. But does Will Parrish leapfrog them? It's going to be close. Back up in here. Who comes down the pit lane? A couple of guys are. Mitchell Collins will. And about half of the field coming down, led by last week's winner at Dover in the 45 machine. Vasquez will remain in the lead. And Will Parrish leapfrog everybody but Elijah Gordon. So watch out for Gordon to potentially be in the catbird seat to clinch this one. To steal this one away, I should say. Everybody coming off the pit lane. We'll see where Gordon is. He's just now entering turn three. Parrish is right on his heels. But meanwhile, back in here, I believe the rest of the pack is going to come down. No! Brennan Wilmington is going to try and do an overcut along with the 16. But this is going to be the main group of guys that comes down. I believe everybody else is going to come down the pit lane with the exception of Wilmington, Clifton, and the Sampson brothers. But here's Vasquez coming down for his final pit stop of the afternoon. And it's going to be four tires. We'll check on the top left-hand side of your screen where Elijah Gordon comes out. Well, there's Mitchell Collins. There's Gordon and Parrish. And Parrish has gained a lot of time on the 88. It's going to be close. It's going to be close between the 45 and the 54. Nope, never mind. So it looks like Vasquez in the 54 may have got the drop on everybody. I don't think these guys are going to play the strategy game correctly. The Sampson brothers, Wilmington, and Clifton, they might be hung out to dry to finish towards the back end of the field. But at the moment, once timing and scoring resets, actually, Vasquez is just now entering turn three. It's going to be dead close if there's a race at all. I don't think so. I don't think they're going to come out better than the way they were. But Vasquez will cruise past everybody. And with 11 laps to go, Diego Vasquez looks to be in position for his first win in the Michelin Barbecue Cup Series, barring a yellow flag coming out. But that definitely jumbled up the pack quite a bit, as Wilmington now files back in third. So this will be a huge points day for Brendan Wilmington. Trying to find where Thompson and Turner are. There's Keegan Thompson. He's currently 22nd. I believe Jesse Turner net lost positions on the pit lane. Yes, he did, back in 35th. So this will be a huge points day for Keegan Thompson, despite finishing towards the middle of the field. But Vasquez has got a 2-second advantage over his teammate. 10 laps to go from Pocono. But it's still far from over. I'm curious to see what the interval is between the 54 and the 45 this time by. Because Collins has a draft from Matt Wolf and a lot of these guys back in here, including Will Parrish. Shout out to Will Parrish for making the strategy work with the extreme undercut. Oh, Collins is closing in on his teammate. He's closed in by half a second. This race is nowhere near over, but just as I say that, Wilmington is going to go to the inside of Matt Wolf. Wilmington has the freshest tires of anyone out here, and we know how he plays strategy on this with the 62 team. A lightning fast pit stop, that's what that team is known for. He is going to go down the inside of Collins. Can he make the pass stick? He should be able to, and he is. Now, how bad did that hurt those guys going side by side, racing with one another? How much did that allow Diego Vasquez to pull away? We'll see what the interval is this time by as they go under the stripe. I think Vasquez pulled away just a little bit. We'll see how much that hurt them. No, it actually helped them. A second now separates Vasquez and Brennan Wilmington, and that extreme overcut may be playing in the favor of Brennan Wilmington and Riley Sampson. I don't know, Cole Sampson has fallen off the cliff. So he's marred all the way in the middle teens. But this race is far from over, and I don't think they're gonna catch Ethan Lewis. I really don't think they're gonna catch Ethan Lewis. We'll see what the interval is. They're 45 last time by. I don't think they're catching Ethan, but Wilmington is definitely gonna catch the 54 of Vasquez. I wouldn't be surprised if Wilmington puts a fastest lap on the board, because that 62 is flying. He is now under half a second away from the 54. It wouldn't be enough to get the points lead, but hey, a win's a win. And given how bad Wilmington has struggled, especially in qualifying, I know he is hungry for a win. He is dying to get to Gatorade Victory Lane, and he's right on the back bumper of the 54. Three wide behind them as Brendan Yodel has popped up in the picture for this win. But Brennan is in the middle of a Yellow Monkey Racing sandwich. I guess it's better than being in the middle of a girl and girl sandwich like Landon Smith Jr. was back in season one at Boston. But he has got to be very careful trying to get around. And hey, did I say careful? Wilmington said screw that. He's going down to the inside of Diego Vasquez. And that may have been the pass for the win. So Wilmington, with an extreme overcut, staying out, takes advantage of the fresh tires. And he looks to be in position to get the job done here from Pocono. But he does have a lot fresher tires than Ethan Lewis does. So could this be a double-edged sword for Wilmington? We'll have to find out. They are closing in on the 7. We'll see how much they close in. They close in another second, but we've got 5 laps to go here from Pocono. Vasquez is not done. He's going to try and set up a counterattack on Wilmington. But how about this for Brendan Yodel? 41st in points, has been pretty much invisible this year. He's been in the Daniel Bouchard category when it comes to how he's been this season, where he's only noticeable when he wrecks. But he's rocking P5 at the moment as Mitchell Collins will go down to the inside. He will take the 00 with him. That's exactly what Wilmington wants to see out of his rearview mirror. But out of his windshield, they are rapidly closing in on lap traffic. If Brennan can just get around the 7, he should be home free. And he's going to get held up by Ethan Lewis going through turn 1. But luckily for him, they're battling for second. Troxel to the inside of the 45 for the second position. But out front, Wilmington will get around Ethan Lewis. But Collins dive bombs the 7 down in the tunnel turn. He wants to get two in a row. He is desperate for two in a row. He is right on the bubble. He wants to make the chase. Troxel is just looking for a win. He dives back down to the inside of Collins for second. All this happening behind Wilmington as they exit turn three. Three laps to go from the tricky triangle. Brennan Wilmington trying to take advantage of everybody else ahead of him in points, struggling. Collins back down to the inside of Troxel, but the more these guys battle, the more that 62 is going to pull away. 2.5 laps to go at the 2.5 mile Super Speedway in Long Pond, Pennsylvania. If you're just tuning in, you've missed a good one. Brennan Wilmington playing the strategy game, doing an overcut, staying out, and he's got the fresh tires, but Troxel is gonna get a draft on him going through turn three. Popsicle sticks in the air, 2 laps to go. Troxel, who was one of the guys that had to come down early on, is gonna go down to the inside of Wilmington. Drama with 2 laps to go. Troxel now out in front. Does he have Wilmington clear? Yes, he does. But Wilmington right on the back bumper of the double zero down Long Pond for the second to final time. Collins is relegated back to third. I don't think he's within striking distance. Oh, Wilmington lost a lot of time through the tunnel turn. He's going to need to run a perfect lap if he wants to have any chance of catching the double zero to get the race lead back. But Thomas Troxel off the final corner, white flag in the air, one more time around the Pocono Raceway. Can Thomas Troxel steal one? Wilmington is going to have 3 corners to set up an attack on the double zero, but he is way out back. I think he used up all of his stuff, unfortunately, getting up to the front of the field. A win quickly going down the drain for the 62. But a win quickly bubbling to the surface for Thomas Troxel. They're out of turn two. Wilmington is going to have one shot, but I think he's too far back to do anything about it. Through the flat turn three, no turn four necessary. And off the final corner, Wilmington going to have one more chance, but not going to get there in time. Thomas Troxel, the Edmonton, Alberta native, will go to Gatorade Victory Lane for the first time in his Mission Barbecue Cup Series career. Thomas Troxel is a winner in the Mission Barbecue Cup Series at Pocono. Wilmington, who looked to get the job done on the pit lane, one position short, and it doesn't get any more heartbreaking than that. Second sucks a big one. But Troxel, the Canadian, becomes the second of the second international driver to win in the Mission Barbecue Cup Series. On the heels of Keegan Thompson, he becomes the second Canadian. Fifth international driver to win in the Mission Barbecue Cup Series behind Fitzwater and the Sampson brothers. And I could be wrong on that, but hey, I think he'll take it. Troxel going to Gatorade Victory Lane. What a race and what a finish. Holy jumping, ladies and gentlemen. So Troxel, who started all the way back. I don't even know where he started. He started in 14th, stayed out under that first caution, and it looks like Juan Rodriguez wrecked, so we'll take a look and see what happened with Rodriguez. But Wilmington, I think if he had another lap, he may have gotten there, had a chance to get around Troxel, but he just used up too much of his stuff way too fast. Collins and Vasquez, third and fourth. Great points day for Yellow Monkey Racing. Matt Wolf rounds out the top five. Yodel, Parrish, Lozano, Fitzwater, and Riley Sampson round out your top 10. And we had no cars finish outside the in the garage area. But we only had 39 cars finish the race on the lead lap, with Ethan Lewis, Roberto Crown Jr., and Josh Williamson having issues. But let's take a quick look and see what happened with Juan Rodriguez. What happened to Juan Rodriguez at the end of the race. He probably just hit the pit wall or something like that. So that'll just be on the bottom, like one of the sides of your screen. But nonetheless, Thomas Troxell, with a pass with two laps to go, is going to Gatorade Victory Lane here at the Pocono Raceway in the Vitamin Water car. And it's a first win for Troxell Perez Racing, so how about that? So, Wilmington, one of his drivers' cars is going to Victory Lane, so he'll take it. Toyota goes 1-2. Once again, the Chevrolet fails to win a race. No surprise there. And the Chevrolets have really got to get their butts in gear, especially guys in the top two in points, Keegan Thompson and Jesse Turner. They run Chevrolets, and if they want a chance at winning the championship, they have got to get their asses in gear. Keegan Thompson finished 21st, and Turner finished 33rd, so really bad points days for those guys. And Wilmington, he was 262 back, so he'll really cut into those leads significantly. But hey, if you liked this type of racing, just wait. We're going road racing next week at the Bridgehampton Race Circuit on July 23rd for the Barstool Sports Long Island Grand Prix at the Bridgehampton Race Circuit. That is going to be a fun one there at that racing facility on Long Island. And we're staying in the tri-state area for just a couple of races, but we are officially under the 10 race threshold when it comes to the race amount of races left in the chase in the season here in the Mission Barbecue Cup Series. It is definitely go time, especially if you're on that bubble. And Thomas Troxell, he was towards the bottom of the field when it comes to points. Actually, he's in 17th, so this win is going to put him in the conversation for the wildcard position. So how about that? A clutch victory for the Edmonton, Alberta native. But that's going to do it here from the Pocono Raceway. Congratulations once again to Thomas Troxell for winning the Jack Frost Big Boulder Ski Resort 400. We'll see you next week up on Long Island at the Bridgehampton Race Circuit for the Barstool Sports Long Island Grand Prix right here on the NASRA. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night, ladies and gentlemen. Here are your point standings after race 16 of the 2022 and our 2003 Mission Barbecue Cup Series season. And from Long Pond, Pennsylvania, this concludes our broadcast on the North American Sim Racing Network from the Tricky Triangle. Eat your veggies, get good sleep, and as always, lads, practice safe sex. Until next time, I've been Trey Wright for the NASRN. Have a great evening, folks.